Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video we will be discussing about one of the components of treatment of BOD, and that is called as trickling filter. So what is trickling filter? I will attach the theory related to trickling filter at the end of this video. You can read that out, but I will be discussing about the formulas now, and I will be discussing one numerical that will cover the complete trickling filter in detail, and nothing will come out of this particular video, that I can assure you. So what is trickling filter? Trickling filter is a component that is used to remove the biological oxygen demand. So basically when it is where it is located, so it is located after the primary sedimentation tank and before the secondary sedimentation tank. Okay, so what happens here, there are three types of trickling filter. Basically one is standard rate trickling filter, another is high rate trickling filter, and there is third one that is called as super high rate trickling filter. Okay, so what happens is, in standard rate trickling filter, there is no recirculation of the discharge from the secondary sedimentation tank. Like in the other components also you have studied about the recirculation. So in standard rate trickling filter there is no recirculation. Because of no recirculation, the loading rate is very less. Now see, there are two terms here. One is HLR, which is called as hydraulic loading rate, and another is OLR. OLR is organic loading rate. Hydraulic loading rate is basically the rate at which the sewage is loaded in the filter, and organic loading rate is basically the rate at which the biological oxygen mass is basically loaded, or we can say the organic component is loaded at this particular rate. So they are basically two different terms. So the efficiency of a standard rate trickling filter can be calculated if you know the organic loading rate. You just have to take the under root, multiply it by 0.0044, add 1 and divide by 100. This will give you the efficiency of a standard rate trickling filter. But you must remember that the units in which this organic loading rate is kept is kilogram per hectare meters per day. But if you want to keep this volume, that is hectare meters, into meter cube, then you will have to change this term to 0.44. Okay, remember any one formula, either in terms of hectare meter or in terms of meter cube. When you keep in meter cube, then you have to replace it by 0.44. when you keep in hectare meters, you have to keep it as 0.0044 under root u. U represents your organic loading rate. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Now let's talk about the high rate trickling filter. In this particular trickling filter, what happens? See, in standard rate trickling filter, since there is no recirculation, because of no recirculation, the hydraulic loading rate, the rate at which the sewage is loaded on the filter, is very less. Because of which, it is almost like stationary, we can say. There is no very large movement. It is very stable and very slow. The sewage moves very slowly from the filter, because of which there are several problems. What problems can arise? Like we can say fly nuisance, also odor problem, also ponding problem, and several other problems. And the rate is slow, then the whole process will be slow. After secondary sedimentation tank, the sewage has to pass through chlorination and several other processes. So if the trickling filter process will be slow, then the every other process after it will be delayed. So that is why standard rate trickling filter is lesser preferred as compared to the other trickling filter. So we use high rate trickling filter, in which we recirculate. This is QR. This is the recirculation. Trickling filter will have a discharge of Q0. It will receive Q0. Then secondary sedimentation tank will send QR. Therefore, trickling filter will release Q0 plus QR. And from secondary sedimentation tank, we will get the original Q0 discharge. How to find the efficiency in this particular case? You can find the efficiency by almost similar formula. But you have to replace U with W1 divided by V1 F1. What is W1, what is V1, what is F1? Let us discuss. W1 is the weight of BOD entering the filter. The BOD weight that is entering this filter, that means you will be given with the organic content. in terms of milligram per liter. Okay, in terms of milligram per liter, in the question they will give you the organic content. Okay, let me read out something for you. Like in one question they have given it to be sewage of BOD. The BOD of the sewage will be given to you. See, organic content is always measured in terms of BOD. Suppose there is an organic content of 120 milligram per liter, then it simply means that it will require 120 milligram per liter of BOD. So in terms of BOD, it will give you, in the question it will give you that what is the BOD of the sewage. So you have to multiply the BOD of the sewage with the discharge. Discharge is in terms of meter cube per second or liter per second. So this will give you multiplication of BOD and Q naught will give you this W1. Okay, so Q naught into S naught. S naught is the BOD that is entering to the trickling filter. So this should be in the units of kilogram per day. Similarly, what is V1? V1 is the volume of the trickling filter that is attached here. Then there is another term F. They can also ask you an objective question, calculate the recirculation factor. F is called as recirculation factor. How can you calculate? This is the formula. 1 plus R divided by 1 plus 0.1 R and the whole square of the denominator. Now what is R here? R is recirculation ratio. They can again ask you in the objective, calculate the recirculation ratio and then calculate the recirculation factor. So recirculation ratio is the ratio of the recirculated discharge to the discharge that is entering the trickling filter. This is QR and this is Q naught. I hope this is clear to everyone out. Now let us discuss about the super high rate trickling filter. What happens? This trickling filter is a single stage trickling filter. Again, to increase the speed of the trickling filter and to increase the speed of the process, we put the trickling filter in two stages. Let me show you how. In this filter only I will amend and I will show you super high rate trickling filter. Now see, this is one secondary sedimentation tank. Now this will release the discharge here and there is one more trickling filter that will be attached and it will again go to another secondary sedimentation tank, SST2 let's say, and then this will be again Q naught. Here also Q naught will come. Here again there will be a recirculation QR and this will be Q naught plus QR. So basically this will happen in two stages. Let us say this is stage 1. So this will be called as stage 2. Okay, so this is called as super high rate trickling filter or two stage high rate trickling filter also it is called as. Now there will be two efficiencies associated with this. This will have eta 1 and this will have eta 2. Eta 1 will be similar as I discussed for high rate trickling filter, that is 100 divided by 1 plus 0.0044 W divided by V1 F1. So this will be efficiency eta 1. Okay, what is W1? W1 is the weight of the biological mass that is entering here, that is weight of BOD that is entering here in terms of kilogram per day. V1 is the volume of this trickling filter. This and this trickling filter are different. This may have some different volume, this may have some different volume. F1 is the recirculation factor for this trickling filter and F1 will use R1. R1 will be the recirculation ratio for this particular stage. Now you have to calculate the efficiency of stage 2. How can you calculate the efficiency of stage 2? So there is formula for this. 1 plus 0.0044 divided by 1 minus eta 1 W2 divided by V2 F2 and the under root of this. So with this you can calculate the efficiency of stage 2. What is W2, what is V2, what is F2? Every component is same, every variable is same, but it is associated with stage 2. W2 is the weight of BOD entering the stage 2. V2 is the volume of the second trickling filter and F2 is the recirculation ratio, recirculation factor for this stage 2. and R value will also be used corresponding to stage 2. The only difference in the efficiency of second stage is that you have to divide it by 1 minus eta 1. That's it. So this is all about the efficiencies of the trickling filter. And let me give you two more formulas that will be very beneficial for you while solving the numericals. And they are corresponding to the surface area and the volume. Suppose you have to calculate the surface area of the trickling filter, then how can you calculate the surface area? So you can calculate the surface area by Q naught. Remember, this is Q naught divided by hydraulic loading rate. This is excluding recirculation. Okay. Also, in another way, you can calculate it by Q naught plus QR divided by hydraulic loading rate including recirculation. So what is this? You can calculate the surface area using this formula. You can check out the units, and when you will convert this, the units, it will result into surface area. Like what are the units of Q naught? You know the units of Q naught are meter cube per second, or let's say liter per day. Suppose we can have any units, it does not matter at all. And what are the units of hydraulic loading rate? So I told you the units of hydraulic loading rate also. So by putting the units of hydraulic loading rate into this particular question, you will get the units of the surface area, that is meter square. I hope this is clear to you all. Now let us discuss about the formula for volume. To calculate the volume, what you can do, Q naught S naught divided by OLR excluding recirculation, also Q naught S naught plus QR SR divided by OLR including recirculation. When you combine the recirculation discharge, then you have to use the organic loading rate including recirculation. Similarly, in this case also, when you only use Q naught, you did not consider the recirculation HLR. HLR will change. When recirculation is introduced, the HLR will increase. In this particular case, HLR will be more. In this particular case, HLR will be less, because recirculation increases the hydraulic loading rate. So similarly, you can also check out the units of this. You know the units of OLR. You also know the units of Q naught into S naught. Q naught is liter per day. This is milligram per liter, so this will result into kilogram per day. Similarly, you can put the units of OLR and you can check this out. So this is all about the theory about it. Now let us move on to the numerical portion, and it will be a very basic numerical, but it will cover everything about this. So the question says that calculate the diameter required for a single stage high rate trickling filter. There is a single stage high rate trickling filter. So this is trickling filter and this is secondary sedimentation tank, and there is some recirculation definitely, because it is a high rate trickling filter. This is QR, this is Q naught, and this is again Q naught. Okay, so what is given, which is to yield the effluent BOD of 20 milligram per liter when treating settled domestic sewage of BOD 120 milligram per liter. That means the BOD that is entering the trickling filter has a BOD of 120 milligram per liter. And when it comes out of the trickling filter, then it has a BOD of 20 milligram per liter. It is given in the question. That means trickling filter has a good efficiency. It converts a sewage of BOD 120 milligram per liter to a sewage of BOD of just 20 milligram per liter. That's it. And wastewater flow is given. That means Q naught is also given to you. And Q naught is 2200 meter cube per day. And what else is given to you? Recirculation discharge is also given to you, that is QR, and it is 4000 meter cube per day. Recirculation discharge is greater than the incoming discharge. That is why without recirculation the hydraulic loading rate is very less. And the depth of the tank is given to you as 1.5 meters. You have to calculate the diameter. So let us denote the depth with small h and the diameter as capital D. You have to calculate this. See, with the incoming BOD and the outgoing BOD, you can calculate the efficiency of trickling filter. What trickling filter does? Trickling filter BOD को remove करता है. तो इसने कितना BOD remove किया? 100 milligram per liter इसने remove कर दिया. 100 milligram per liter is removed. That means X percentage of 120 equals to 100. That is कितना percentage है? ये इसका तो वो 100 divided by 120 into 100 से निकाल लेंगे. So this will come out to be 83.33%. So this is the efficiency of this trickling filter. It has removed 83.33% of the BOD. So when you will do 83.33% of 120 milligram per liter, it will give you 20 milligram per liter. In the outgoing sewage, still 20 milligram per liter BOD is there. It has not removed 100%. If the efficiency would have been 100%, then the outgoing BOD would be 0 milligram per liter. But its efficiency is 83.33%. So this is the efficiency of trickling filter. Now you can use the formula for efficiency. You know the formula for efficiency as 100 divided by 1 plus 0.0044 V1 divided by, W1 divided by V1 F1. This is the formula. W1 should be in the units of kilogram per day. F1 has no units and V1 should be in terms of hectare meter, kilogram per hectare meter day. Okay, so let us calculate W1 first. What is W1? W1 is Q0 into S0. What is Q0? Q0 is 2200 millimeter cube per day. And S0 is 120 milligram per liter. You have to get it in the units of kilogram per day. So 2200 into 1000. This is liters per day. And this is 120 milligram per liter. Liter and liter will cancel out and milligram per day. This is in milligram per day. So divided by 10 to the power 6. So when you do so, you will get W1 as 264 kilogram per day. This is the value of W1. You got one variable. F1. You have to calculate F1. Volume cannot be calculated because it is not given. From the volume, by dividing the volume with the height, you will get the surface area. And from the surface area, you can get the diameter because it is in circular section. I hope this is clear. Now let's calculate the value of, I'm rubbing this portion. Let's calculate the value of F1. What is F1? F1 is 1 plus R divided by 1 plus 0.1 R and the square of this. For this you need R. R is 4000 divided by 2200. So this will come out to be 1.81. So when you will put this in this equation, F1 will come out to be 2.02. You have F1, you have W1. Replace this in this equation and obtain the value of V1. So when you will solve this, V1 will come out to be 687 meter cube. This is the volume of V1. You know volume equals to surface area multiplied by height. So surface area can be calculated as volume divided by height, 687 divided by 1.5. So it will give a surface area. Whatever it is the surface area, you can calculate and you can equate it by pi by 4 d square. From this equation, you can calculate the value of d and the final answer is d is, after solving this equation using a calculator, I have already solved it and the value of d is coming out to be 23.2 meters. So this is the required value of the diameter. I hope this particular portion is completely clear to you all. And let me once again boost up your memory with that unit comparison part. I skipped that. See, surface area is Q0 divided by hydraulic loading rate. Let's not get into the detail of including recirculation here. We just need to check out the units. So Q has a unit of liter per day, let us suppose, and HLR has a unit of meter per day. Sorry. Hydraulic loading rate will have a units of In this terms, it is usually given. When you cancel this out, it will turn out to be meter per day only. Or liter per day can be converted into meter cube per day as well. And this will be written as meter per day. So when you cancel out the units, it will turn out to be meter square. So that is equal to surface area. That is why Q naught by HLR will give you the surface area. Now Q naught into S naught divided by OLR gave you volume. Let us check this out. Q naught is liter per day. S naught is milligram per liter, or let's say kilogram per liter. So this will cancel out. And what are the units of OLR? OLR is in terms of kilogram per meter cube day. This is in single cell. So kilogram per day, meter cube day per kilogram. So this will cancel out, day will cancel out, it will turn out to be meter cube only. So this is the unit of volume. So this is why this formula will give you volume and this formula will give you surface area. So this is all about the complete process and the complete numerical of trickling filter. You can read out the theory related to the trickling filter I have attached here. Thank you everyone, and do not forget to subscribe.